have been Toastmasters. What do you think is a basic requirement for evaluation?
Understanding the speech.
Yeah, you have got to understand the speech. Okay. Why are you doing an evaluation? Okay, let me rephrase the question. Why are you doing an evaluation?
To provide feedback.
To
provide the feedback.
To provide the feedback. Okay.
To whether the speech is hitting its objective or not.
Okay.
To help the speaker improve.
Yeah, that's the answer probably. You are evaluating just because you want your speaker to improve and you want to make the speech a better speech the next time somebody is attempting it. As simple as that. Right? Now, how many of you believe evaluation also is a speech? Your evaluation also is a speech where you can carry some notes. Okay? Remember that. Now, what do you think is needed to make a speech a good speech? What is a fundamental requirement of a good speech?
Message.
Proper organization.
Proper organization.
Making sure that the message is conveyed, not just the content.
Making sure that the message is conveyed. Okay, even before you deliver your speech, what is it that you look into?
Content.
Content. What are the traits of a great speaker?
What people can attract to it.
Connecting to the audience, right? So understanding your audience is primordially important before you even attempt your speech. If you are not understanding your audience and you are still writing a speech, thank you. You have a recipe for disaster. Okay. So, point one, you have got to understand your audience. We will do the same thing with our speech, which is called evaluation. Who is your audience for an evaluation?
The person who is giving the speech.
The speaker. The speaker who has just given his or her speech is the only audience for your evaluation. Yes or no?
Yes.
Got it?
Yeah.
So, when you are coming onto the dais, you have only one objective. To connect to that one particular person, speak for 3.5 minutes, and in those 3.5 minutes, be as objective as possible to improve his speech and make the speaker a better speaker. That's it. There is no other objective for your evaluation. Are we clear on this? Okay. Now that we know who our audience is, do we really need to maintain eye contact with everybody in the room?
Still yes.
No. Not needed. Those are all brownie points. After you are done with everything good in your speech, probably you can attempt all that stuff. Okay, but that's not your primary focus. Okay, your primary focus is one person. If Nitin is giving his speech, Nitin is your single focal point for your entire evaluation. That's it. Nobody is really going to care whether you are talking to entire audience, whether you are greeting entire audience. No, my entire focus of 3.5 minutes is to see to it that I am giving the best possible feedback to Nitin about his speech and not on him. Remember, you are evaluating what? A speech. You are never evaluating a person. Okay, now that we have defined, okay, how do we, see, one of the most important things that we do in a speech is what? Connecting to our audience with the first statement. With the first statement you are not connecting to your audience, you are doing a mistake again. Okay, you can't either, I mean, you have got to tell your audience that you are either one amongst them. You have got to connect to them in one way or the other, right? Now, how do you connect to your audience? Have you ever seen great speakers who have just been invited to do a keynote address or something? How do they start their speeches?
Like it depends
imagine,
on the audience.
Imagine Qualcomm CEO comes here. What do you think would be his first thing when he is addressing all of you?
He will greet us all.
Greet, okay.
Start on something which catches the pulse of everyone.
They'll start on something that is
tangential.
Essentially yours. Many people when they visit a new place, they start off with what? By acknowledged in the place. This is the first time I am in Hyderabad. Or, you know, all these RJs overplay this when they start their shows. Good morning, Hyderabad. What are they effectively trying to do here?
Connect.
They are trying to connect to something which you are already a part of. Got it? So how do we connect to our target speaker today? How do you connect to your target speaker? What do you think is the best way for an evaluator to connect to the target speaker, to the person who has just given his or her speech?
First, greet him, and then probably, you know, pay a compliment for the speech.
Mm-hmm. Greet and pay a compliment. Great. So some people start off like this, right? Good evening, one and all. Nitin in particular. Well, that was a great speech, Nitin. There was conviction, blah, 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 blah. I think Sudeep has come. I think someone needs to escort him inside, right? What are other ways of connecting to a speaker?
Depends on the what he is delivering. So, take that main crisp point in his speech and greet.
Yeah, probably that's the best thing to do. You have heard a 7-minute speech, right? Now, every speech appeals to you at one particular level. There will be something that would actually strike a chord with you. Yes or no? Every speech has got something in it to strike a chord with the audience. Else, I mean, it's not a speech, right? So, the aim of any speaker is to touch base with the audience. Hence, every speaker will try and do something that will strike a chord with the audience. Now, what was that one point in Nitin's speech that I got connected with? And remember very clearly here, this is your opening statement, avoid flattery like plague. The last thing I as a speaker want to listen from an evaluator is soft, soap, sharp in the first line of his speech.
So, no compliment.
No flattery. Compliment should be there. Flattery should not be there. There is a thin line of difference. For example, your name?
Ambrish.
So Ambrish has just joined Toastmasters 2 weeks down the line. Ambrish will come and give a CC1. Okay. Now, if I being his evaluator will come on to the dais and say, that was a great speech, Ambrish. For a beginner, that was really good. He'll feel good. If I say, Ambrish, probably in the last few days, I have been evaluating 3 or 4 people. All of them were CC1. But you know what? Your speech is standing out from all those CC1s. I'll tell XYZ. That's praise on a pedestal. Still okay. But if you say, Ambrish, you should actually be thinking of this speech as an ISC speech. Last year, I have seen division champions. But you know what? None of them had such a speech. I mean, Ambrish knows that you are flattering him. I have given a first speech, yeah. I mean, I know, I'm just beginning my journey. So avoid flattery. But what you've got to do is probably if, I mean, Nitin has given a speech and, I mean, imagine Nitin has given a speech regarding, he has given a persuasive speech on ozone layer depletion. Okay? And he said, guys, please don't use too much of refrigeration. We are actually having a lot of ill effects due to it. Imagine that was the concept of his speech. Just imagine for some time. Now, for example, if I get connected to the fact that what we are enjoying on the earth is actually a debt that we are taking from our kids. Imagine there's a line of that sort. Probably you can start off with that line by saying, yeah, true. When I was a kid, I probably enjoyed the most even in summer. And today my son or my daughter can't even imagine get out into the heat before 4 o'clock, whereas I remember playing around 3. Start with something where you are there, where his speech is also there, and try to make that bridge between you and the target speaker, so that he begins to be receptive. He starts listening to everything that you start saying. Okay, so that's extremely important. That's what you are supposed to do in the first 30 seconds of your speech or your evaluation. Okay? First 30 seconds, you are not going to do anything other than building that bridge between you and the speaker who has just finished the speech. Okay, now, based on your rehearsals, based on your proficiency, your ability to figure out that one statement and create a very crisp statement or a coin a quick quote around it, that will come based on your rehearsals. Now, how do I rehearse? I'll tell at the end. How do I rehearse for an evaluation contest? I'll tell at the end. Okay, but then remember your first 30 seconds, you're just going to connect to the speaker with one part of this, with some part of the speech that really made an impact on you, and be as genuine as possible. Don't make this statement for the sake of making it. For all reasons, people are not idiots. They'll catch you at the first moment, the drop of the hat, they're going to catch you if you're just there to flatter them. Okay, so that's your point one. Again, now we'll come back to our speech structure. You have connected to your audience, okay? Then what are you going to tell in your speech?
Positives.
You're finally going to attain your objective. See, every speech has an objective. In this, when I'm saying evaluation is a speech, evaluation objective is to make the speaker a better speaker and the speech a better speech. Nothing more than that, right? Now, if you get to travel to Indore just by doing that job 3 times, fantastic. And do it for the 4th time also in Indore. Okay. Otherwise, cool. As long as I am helping the speaker, I am adding value to the universe's time, fine. Got it? Now, in a speech, to achieve our objective, we normally use stories. Now, what will be the stories in an evaluation? The positives and the negatives that the speaker has committed. Yes or no? Now, what all do I comment in a speech is a very big question. What all do I recommend in a speech is also a big question. But to understand what all do I comment and what all do I recommend, I have got to understand one thing which is even more fundamental regarding a speech. Now, what are the parts of a speech? Parts of speech.
Opening, body, and closing.
Opening, body, conclusion. Uh-huh. What are parts of speech? To me, there are only 2 parts in a speech. One is content, the other is presentation. Content is the idea with which the speaker has come and all the supporting material around it. For example, I want to drive home a point that speed thrills but kills. If that's my specific purpose of the speech, I have a lot of supporting material where I'll talk about accidents, that, this, that. You know, I from Mohammad Azharuddin's son till a recent death on Outer Ring Road, I can talk about 101 things, right? But then how are those stories contributing to my conclusion is what is my content part is all about. Are you getting it? My presentation is about how well I am making a transition, what sort of language I am using, yes or no? How quickly am I there at the point or not? How was my body or body language? Was I pausing at the right place? Was I giving enough emotional thrust in my voice when there was an emotional incident in the speech? All this is presentation. Yes or no? So you've got content, you've got presentation. Okay. Now, in the evaluations you have seen till date, if you have to look at the evaluators, what was the percentage of the concentration on presentation and what percentage of the evaluators concentrated on content?
Presentation, they will give more.
How many of you have seen people actually attacking content or complimenting content? Yeah. Now you can be unique when you are concentrating more on content, because content at the end of the day is the king. See, if I am giving a speech, I am telling that I am achieving an objective through my speech. If I am telling that, I should substantiate that realization or whatever that conclusion is with good examples, good stories, right? If the stories don't have strong content, my speech is doomed. Yes or no? But as a speaker, my objective is to get my point across. So what will I do? If I think the content is weak, again I am saying quote unquote, if I think my content is weak, I'll make my presentation as flowery as possible. Because at the end of the day, if the presentation is too good, finding out faults in content is very less. is the chance of finding fault in content is very tough. Got it? Now this is a trap that a speaker is going to set for you, set for any of his audience. If you look at political speeches or speeches with politicians, 99.9% they would be trying to set you in that emotional trap. Yes or no?
Yes.
Now there is something called as emotion, there is something called as logic. Both of them should be there in a speech. But emotion should never mask logic. Yes or no? If your emotion is actually masking your logic, your audience is actually going for a toss without realizing what you are telling. Your speech is more dangerous than a good speech. Now, as an evaluator, try to analyze what is the tool that the speaker is trying to use. Is the speaker committing himself or herself to the content or to the logic, or is the speaker overplaying with your emotions? Be very, very careful about this, my dear friends. And just because I said attack content, don't attack the idea of the speech. Attack the way the support material of the speech was given. Are you getting it? There's a fine line of difference. Don't say, Nitin, who the hell are you to talk about ozone layer depletion? You are working in Microsoft. What data do you have? This should be spoken by a scientist, probably. Don't do that. Try to figure out if the logic is going bad. Try to figure out where all he's going across the line or going away from the line in terms of logic. Are you getting it? This is very, very key. Try to understand the logic of the speech and the emotional part of the speech. Now, when I'm saying logic of the speech is starting here. Okay, with the problem of the protagonist. Right? And the speech is ending here, where the protagonist achieved the objective of the speech. So, from here to here, the path that they are taking should be foolproof. Now, go there and tell them that this story probably was not that logical. Or if the path is very well defined, okay, then probably go there and tell them that, yeah, I really loved the way you convinced me. Probably after your second story, I really, really got convinced that this was the right way to do. Okay. Sometimes there are some stereotypes that are introduced in a speech. What are those stereotypes? I am poor, hence I am good. That's there in movies also. For example, in Indian movies, a typical trap is that anyone who is son of a rich father is bad. Son or daughter. And they are with loose morals. Who gives them the authority to say that?
No.
There's a stereotype. Figure out if there are any stereotypes being used in terms of content. That was a rich bungalow. I walked in and the owner was talking to me in a smirking manner. What if the owner was busy? And you're really eating into his time? Nobody questions these. Are you getting it? Try to figure that out and tell them, you instead of saying you have stereotype, don't again use the word that you have stereotype. That again will get you negative marks. Probably say, instead of that character was just there to smirk at you, you would have told me more about them than saying that he was rich and living in a posh house. That doesn't make someone smirk at you. Are you getting it? These are the stereotypes that are built into our minds, my dear friends. Try attacking these.